We want to solve the given exponential equations by using like bases, which means you want to isolate the exponential part on one side of the equation and then write both sides of the equation with the same base. If we can do this, then the exponents will be equal. In general, we say if a to the power of m is equal to a to the power of n, then m is equal to n. Again, if we have exponential expressions equal to each other with the same base, the exponents must be equal. So in our first example, the first step is to isolate 5 raised to the power of x. And since this 7 is connected by multiplication, we'll divide both sides by 7. 7 over 7 simplifies to 1. So we have 5 raised to the power of x equals 875 divided by 7 is equal to 125. Now that we've isolated the exponential part on one side, we want to try to write 125 with a base of 5. And since 125 is equal to 5 times 25, and 25 is equal to 5 times 5, 125 is equal to 3 factors of 5, which we can write as 5 to the third. So we have 5 to the power of x equals 5 to the third. Now that these are equal and the bases are the same, the exponents must equal each other. Therefore, x is equal to 3. In our second equation, we want to isolate 3 raised to the power of x. So we need to undo the subtraction and undo this multiplication. So we'll start by adding 32 to both sides of the equation. It'll be 0, so we have 6 times 3 to the power of x equals, this would be 1,458. And now we'll divide both sides by 6. Again, this simplifies to 1. So we have 3 raised to the power of x equals 1,458 divided by 6 is equal to 243. Now we want to see if we can write 243 with a base of 3. So 243 is equal to, with a number like this, it's helpful to remember that if the sum of the digits is divisible by 3, so is the number. And since 2 plus 4 plus 3 is equal to 9, which is divisible by 3, so is this number. So it's going to be 3 times some number. It's actually 3 times 81. 81 is equal to 9 times 9, and each 9 is equal to 3 times 3. Since 243 is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 factors of 3, we can write this as 3 to the power of x equals 3 to the fifth. Now that these are equal and we have a common base of 3, we know the exponents must be equal, therefore x is equal to 5. Okay, we'll look at two more examples in the next video.